In this chapter, you'll discover how the BIM server can be managed either locally from the server machine, or remotely from a different machine within the office via the local area network, or even via the internet. Being able to access and manage the BIM server remotely provides great flexibility for BIM managers to set up teamwork projects and to manage users and access rights from anywhere around the world. On the server machine where the GRAPHISOFT BIM server application is installed, you can control the BIM server via the BIM Server Control Center application. With this application, you have full control over how the BIM server is configured, as well as the server manager functionalities with which you can configure the shared projects, users, roles, libraries, and even monitor server activity. On a remote machine, you can control the BIM server via the BIM Server Manager application, which you must install separately using the ArchiCAD installation DVD. With the BIM Server Manager application on a remote computer, you have exactly the same functionality as with the Server Manager on the server machine. However, you do not have access to the other functions of the GRAPHISOFT BIM Server Control Center application for configuring the preferences of the BIM server itself. On the server machine where the GRAPHISOFT BIM server has been installed, use the BIM Server Control Center interface to manage the BIM server. Let's see how it works. Open the BIM Server Control Center. Right-click the BIM Server icon in the Windows taskbar or at the Mac menu bar, and select Open GRAPHISOFT BIM Server Control Center from the context menu to open the application. The first panel of the Control Center gives you basic information about the BIM server and lets you manually start and stop the BIM server by clicking the relevant button. The BIM server status should be on running, because during the installation process, we set it to start automatically along with the operating system. If the BIM server is not running, click the Start Server button. Click the Info button to bring up the About This BIM Server dialog with further information about the BIM server. The lower half of the dialog lists the installed modules of the BIM server. In our case, only the version 17 module is listed. For a detailed explanation about the modular BIM server, click on the relevant link in the dialog box. This will open the GRAPHISOFT Help Center in your default browser and display additional information about the modular BIM server. Close the browser. Please note that it's paramount that the BIM server and the client ArchiCAD versions are of the same build number so they can communicate with each other. You can always check the build number of the BIM server in this dialog. The build number of the ArchiCAD client version can be displayed by activating the About ArchiCAD menu command. This is available from the ArchiCAD menu on Macs and from the ArchiCAD help menu on Windows operating systems. The build number is displayed in the lower left corner of the ArchiCAD splash screen. The Check for Updates button allows you to make sure you are running the latest version of the BIM server available. By clicking this button, your default browser will open and will list available updates. Please always download and install the latest updates for both the BIM server as well as for ArchiCAD. Click Close to return to the main page of the GRAPHISOFT BIM Server Control Center. The second panel of the Control Center dialog box launches the BIM Server Manager, the central interface for managing shared teamwork projects, users, roles, and libraries. Let's have a look at its functions briefly before going into the details of each. Click on the Server Manager to continue. Notice that in the title bar, Localhost is written in parentheses. This means that you are currently managing the local BIM server, whose Server Manager application was launched from its control center. On the left side of the dialog box, you can select any of the listed themes for further configuration. You will be guided through each theme of the Server Manager in the following chapters of this guide. For now, click Close at the bottom right to go back to the Control Center. In the Control Center dialog box, click Preferences to open it. In the BIM Server Preferences, you can modify all the parameters that you previously set during the installation process of the BIM server, except the location of the default library folder. We will not detail these parameters since they were explained earlier. Click Cancel to close this dialog. In the Control Center window, click Create Link to open its dialog box. In the Create Link dialog box, you can save a link file to the BIM server to use with the server manager on remote machines to find the server if it does not appear automatically. Click Cancel for now to leave this dialog without saving a link file. Up to now, you have seen, in brief, the main functions of the BIM Server Control Center and the server manager on the local machine. Now let's see how to access the BIM server remotely from a different machine. You can install the BIM Server Manager separately on any remote machine to manage the BIM server. For the purposes of this training, you do not need to use a remote machine. You can use the separate BIM Server Manager application that is automatically installed with the BIM server. Let's see how this works. Locate the BIM Server Manager application located in the GRAPHISOFT BIM Server folder of your computer. This folder is located in the Programs folder on Windows or in the Applications folder on Mac. Double-click the BIM Server Manager application to launch it. In the appearing dialog box, select the BIM server you would like to access and identify yourself. You must be a server administrator for the BIM server you would like to manage. Details for the server administrator were set during the installation process when we installed the BIM server. Choose the BIM server name from the Select BIM Server pop-up list, then enter Lead Architect into the Username field and enter the previously specified password into the Password field, then click OK. Now the BIM Server Manager dialog box opens, showing the current logged-in user. The username is in parentheses in the title bar, and the BIM server is currently being managed. You can also log in as a different user by clicking on the icon and identifying yourself. You can change the BIM server to be managed by clicking on the pop-up menu in the Choose BIM Server field and selecting a different server from the list. The rest of the functions of the BIM Server Manager are the same as when the Server Manager is launched from the BIM Server Control Center. In this chapter, you've seen how simply and easily the BIM Server can be managed on the server machine. The BIM Server can be controlled remotely from anywhere around the world via the Internet, providing BIM managers with great flexibility to access the servers and manage the shared projects, user accounts, and access rights.